of meta characters. In the qualifiers, they did face, I believe, LN to get into this Bon Bon. And being able to lock in with this Dream Witch, Grizzly, could this, me and Grizzly have talked about this time and time again, how the Dream Witch, is it the season of the Dream Witch? We are going to find out after we see this very hype video to get into that match. OSM versus GD. Noninho spawning right here at the corner house with his Dream Witch. So let's see how which survivor he'll go after first, because the mechanic is out to play. But going for the Leech of the Seer, not wasting any time, just making sure he's going to be as proactive as possible, making sure that he's not going to be able to utilize his owl in time. Big hit for Noninho. Big swing at the start of this round.
Very, very good for Noninho right here, finding out where the Seer is so early in the game and giving them a hit. If we look at the left, always keep in mind the decoding progress. But at the same time, of course, we have different survivors that might be a better target. So there we go. Look at that. Really making out where he's coming from. Putting down the Patroller. Very, very crucial trait right here when you play the Dream Witch, because that is just giving the survivor such a hard time to actually escape. Yeah. We can see Noninho putting pressure on here. Oh, wow. Seer is having the owl. We have the the leeches roaming around. But that owl might actually prevent the damage from happening and giving him more time to actually get away.
Yeah, Noninho still being very patient, just really tunneling the Seer. And he's, as Gaming Grizzly mentioned, the left side of the screen, some ciphers are being popped. Oh, Noninho changing his target, going for the mechanic. And this could be actually a great way of adding a little more pressure and trying to force survivors to go for those heals, because now we have a injured Seer. And Noninho forcing his way, going for the blink and changing traits. Oh, I believe still keeping it. And look at that, going for the hit on the mechanic.
Very, very nice.
He still has Patroller, my bad. He was just switching. Again, I get so discombobulated when it comes to Dream Witches.
Yeah, totally understandable. Totally understandable. At the same time, as you already mentioned, we see Mechanic is down, which is a great find because it is the main decoder. But at the same time, Noninho was not able to figure out where the doll is at the moment. So that means there is an additional decoder on the ground. And if we look in the bottom left, we saw it a few moments ago. That the doll is still decoding. We can see now the fort is coming in for the rescue, and my favorite skin, it is! What a stun in the Hermes shoe skin. Absolutely fantastic rescue right here. But wow. We also saw Noninho doing the best that he could do. He was putting down another leech. We have seen this over and over again. Late game, a lot of leeches, a lot of pressure on the survivors.
Those are definitely the keys to victory when it comes to Dream Witches, the proactivity of leeching survivors and just spreading their attention out to these injured survivors. Now, speaking of injured, the Seer eating that one hit, probably taking his round on that rocket chair, because the mechanic was able to get out of sight and also does not have any more of that leech. So now shifting the attention over to the Flash as he's trying to recuperate in this matchup. And you see that it's very dangerous that you still have this Priestess as well as Mechanic roaming free in Eversleeping Town.
Great job from Noninho, now having the Seer on the chair, leeching the Seer to have another leech on the ground. We saw that they were getting rid of the leeches. And the thing is, right here, the Cypher Machines are getting popped. We have three Cypher Machines done. Oh, we have the doll coming in, I assume, to relocate for another cypher.
Mm-hmm. Excellent blink hit. Oh gosh, yeah. In this other other side of the map, the forward again, doing his work, able to stun the leech of the seer just to break free the flash.
We also have to keep in mind that they are they are taking their turns on the rocket chair. So we saw that the mechanic was the first survivor on the rocket chair. Then we had fantastic stun right here. Then we had the seer on the rocket chair. And that is just buying the more time for the survivors. And considering that we have a mechanic, the time to decode the cipher machine is already reduced a little bit by the doll. So they are putting a lot of speed on the ground right now, healing up, trying to get rid of these leeches as well, and just preparing for the late game because, oh, fantastic blink hunting down the forward right here. Again, we can see how they are trying to get rid of these leeches, because these leeches might be the game-changing factor 8 game.
Oh yeah, it could definitely snowball, it could definitely it could haunt them as the game moves on. And we see that some pressure is being put on these ciphers, so Noninho's attention is being split four ways, especially now that the mechanic's doll already was used up to heal that priestess. Wanted order is with that said priestess, and the priestess trying to go for that save gave him a holy key for that exit, and we see the productivity of Noninho just switching followers just so he knows the best. Wait! Oh wow! Hits the priestess. Everyone has been down in this game.
Yeah, but exactly that's the thing. Like she, Noninho is bringing down a lot of survivors, but at the same time they are taking their turns, which is just buying time for the survivors. And if we look at the decoding progress right now on the left, we see that they started two more. And instead of two, they started three cipher machines because. Again, you want to spread out these cipher machines against the Dream Witch. If the Dream Witch is having a lot of leeches on the ground, it's so extremely difficult to concentrate on one cipher machine because, of course, there can be a lot of leeches around and it's almost impossible to bring that pop into the game, and therefore spreading out the cipher machines that you are priming is a very, very good strategy.
Yeah, and something to know in IVC, they actually did just that, as you mentioned, Gaming Grizzly, that OSM was really known for priming two ciphers, and that's what they're doing now as they heal up, as they try to defend themselves away from and get those anti-curses down. Because everyone is one hit away from going down, and everyone has seen their round, a injury, and some of them also have seen the rocket chair, which is the Flash and Hata. So now we see more leeches being put, a lot of pressure. Now we see two ciphers that are close to being primed. Again, you don't want to rest on your laurels just yet, because Noninho is being very patient, just making sure he doesn't overextend himself for him to regret it later on, and just making sure that he pays attention to each and every survivor on this map.
And as we can see, there are a total of two leeches right now on the field, and great job from the survivors right here. Every single survivor is now having that cursed mark which they can use to actually get rid of the leeches.
Right.
And that can be very, very useful later in the game, because you can just take that leech, you can get rid of the leech to 99%, and then you can just heal yourself and get rid of the leech just when you need it. And there we see the priestess on the chair. You mentioned it for the first time. Every single survivor is going down, but again, not a single survivor has been eliminated yet. And look at the cipher progress. It looks really, really good for the survivors, but at the same time, Dream Witch very well for late games. That might be all Sears trying to get in for the rescue. We have to remember there are a lot of ciphers being almost done, but almost done doesn't mean done.
Exactly. So the Flash trying to add more, but oh, the blink of the Flash was too fast for that. And now moving over to some pallets, but not quite. Noninho able to catch up, and the Flash is going down, but we are seeing a rescue did just happen while that sequence played out in front of us, ladies and gentlemen. Again, we see that one cipher that is just one tap away from it to pop already. And another, wow, they're working on another cipher as well, as you see the forward with your favorite skin getting helping the priestess just get the anti-curse away and going for those heals. They know they want to play this game to the long haul, and they're still trying to manage as much resources as possible, because we know that the Dream Witch likes choking out the survivor's resources till they really have no other choice than to just try to survive as much as possible once the leeches are intact.
Very, very right, and I still think it's very, very crucial for the survivors right now what they are doing. And nice hit. It is so close, but you can't just finish off these ciphers. There's so much pressure. Nice hit with the blink, really getting that gap before the priestess was able to actually use that teleportation. And that priestess wanted to go for the rescue, but sadly now the flash is out of the game, because when the priestess was taking that hit, it was making it almost impossible to go for the rescue, because she would go down by the leech that was protecting the chair. Fantastic work from No Nino, really knowing where to put these leeches, where to put the pressure, and what to protect in this specific time and moment. And right now in the bottom left, it's always very important to check the bottom left every now and then to get crucial data on what is happening on the field. Getting rid of the leeches, again, great strategy for late game for the survivors, just trying to get rid of as many leeches as possible.
Yeah, that sequence that you highlighted, I just got that pop, is that Nonino's defense is really good. Knows which survivor to prioritize, especially if you're a seasoned Dream Witch. You want to be able to know when to stop tunneling a survivor, when to start going for a defense when you're camping. Know when to change traits, which he did. He went for a patroller first, now went with Blink. One cipher remaining. We still see three survivors on this map, but again, as you mentioned, one more hit and they'll be going down, and they've seen their rounds on the rocket chair, but this priestess is being healed up once again. Blink hit just to hit the priestess, and no more leech there, so we only have one leeched main body survivor here for the Dream Witch. So this could be advantageous for OSM,
and as you can see, leech is just being placed right at the cipher machine, and that is the cipher machine that is almost done, really preventing the survivors to pop that last cipher. But that is what we talked about earlier, it's crucial to separate and to get different ciphers done, and therefore we can already see a different cipher machine is halfway done, and the third cipher machine that they started, I think that's one of the few matches where we see all cipher machines being touched. And
you're right, actually. He's touching all the ciphers just to again spread out the attention of this Dream Witch. And you see that he did leech the most vulnerable of all the survivors, which is the mechanic, because she does have half life. The forward and the priestess are looking pretty healthy, but as I say that, the blink hit will tap that forward just for him to have one more hit, and he will be down. Just to note the resources, the holy key is still being replenished, as well as the mechanic having that perfume bottle. So let's see if that'll play into factor as we push for the late game.
For me, the question is, we can see that they're trying to heal up, they're trying to prepare for the late game, right? But how are they planning on popping that last cipher? Are they going to finish the one that is halfway done because the one that is almost done is getting protected? Or are they trying to actually heal up and take hits while they are decoding, so they have enough time during the hit animation to pop off that cipher? That could be, and that might actually be what they are going for. You can see it. No, it's protected by two.
I know. Oh, so wow. No, Nino is just so good at answering and defending the cipher and answering the plays that are being put in front of him. And he's just, he has a leeched follower right there, just in case anyone wants to try anything funny with that cipher. And you saw that they're trying to gain as much resources as you can, but as they're spreading out the attention of this Dream Witch, you know what? They're also kind of spread out to not be able to heal, not be able to defend, and the resources are being depleted as Little Boy will be going to the rocket chair.
And what is unfortunate is that the second cipher machine that they were working on is actually quite close to the one that is already being protected. So that makes it easier for No Nino to actually protect the two cipher machines that they almost primed, and more difficult for OSM to actually get that last cipher pop. It is very, very intense. We can see now only two survivors, both injured, are left in the game, making it extremely difficult to really get that cipher pop and to get these survivors out of here. There we go. We can see the leech is going right up on the forward. And ooh. Nice body block with the main body just going through the window, forcing the forward to stay inside the building and allowing the leech to just hit that forward, bring it down. And that is what we will see. We will see the forward going down. We will see next up the mechanic going down. And even if the forward will get up, concentration will go back to the forward and you will just bring down a back and forth game, basically. Back and forth game, because you want to get that four survivor elimination.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. Especially starting things out with such a, on a big note, on a high note here for Nornino. The nine Malmos, the forward is going up and he really wants to pop the cypher just so he can help his comrade up. But man, Nornino is so good. He's doing it again. Oh my gosh, he blocked the window for nine Malmos to get hit once again. And he already used up his self heal Grizzly. And there we go. GG's will be called. Nornino starting things off on a huge note for GD. Having that backdoor exit is definitely something that the Last Human does not want to deal with. So a very respected ban there. So let's see as we head into the match.
Yes, and it's a very, very, very good ban. Basically the only ban that you definitely need on this map. If you look at the buildings, if you look at the chances that you're giving the survivors, if they can bring a priestess on this map, it only makes sense to ban her. Right now we can see the Last Human finding the Seer early in the game, a good target to just put down another leech. Again, that is the main task of the Dream Witch, just putting down is nice, putting down these leeches and putting more pressure on the survivors. Also want to mention, we saw the Tomy skin previously and I absolutely loved it. It's a beautiful skin. Was trying to hit the Seer, was trying to predict the vault of the pallet, but did not happen. We have the Patroller yet again, and that might be a little bit difficult for the Seer to get away. So now we will most likely see the first happening quite soon. We can see the forward getting back to the Cypher Machine while the Seer is getting a little bit more. Oh, what, taking the hit though?
Yeah, they trade there, but the Seer still has the owl to use to extend his kite and really just give his team enough time to prop up at least two ciphers, because right now those have been the ones that have been moving the most. Mike and making his way towards the graveyard to better utilize the structures here. He's going to wait for that dream to... Oh, wow, drops the pallet, but no! Oh, wow.
I was watching the tiny screen in the bottom left, and I could see exactly what the Seer was doing, was really timing that pallet, was missing it by a millisecond, and that was allowing to switch in the right moment. We saw the Ford was getting ready to rescue. It's now getting a Patroller on. That is extremely good for OSM. Again, they need a 5-point game as well. This is a little bit of a deja vu almost, because we have the Dream Witch on the ever-sleeping town again. And if we are seeing another 5-point game, I'm very excited to see how it will happen again. Dream Witch puts a lot of pressure on the crown, but at the same time...
Lower left side of the screen, the forward gets that stun rescue. Excellent stuff. Kit was loading that one up. The Patroller was great on the forward just to be able to chair the survivor without any harassment, but Kit able to stun and get that perfect rescue now gives the second chance for the Seer to rebound kite. And now we see that the Seer gets, the leech is following him. Oh, but the owl, excellent, blocks it and also gets rid of that leech. So this Seer really is buying so much time for his teammates, Grizz.
And at the same time, this time we can see that the mechanic is having all the time that she needs to use the door and to decode these cypher machines. We can see two cypher machines already have been popped. The third one is almost ready and two more are being worked on. We can see another survivor goes down yet again. Good play from the Last Human, bringing down the Seer. Mm-hmm. And he knows that the fort is waiting for him.
Exactly, yeah. He wants to make sure that he has it, all his bases covered. Doesn't want to pick up just yet. Forward is going for that stun.
Yes! Fantastic usage of the second leech that was prepared to actually block off that stun and actually giving him a hit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Last Human really knows how to defend and go on the offense with this Dream Witch. So second time on the rocket chair for that Seer. Another Cypher is about to get popped, leaving two Cyphers remaining. Another Blink. Oh my gosh, switching traits. But then eats that hit and saves the Seer once again. The forward is down, but that Seer, very important because that's his last time on that chair.
That's very important. But the thing is, there's no leech going after the Seer currently, which allows the Seer to get a little bit of distance. And if we look at the Cypher machines, Survivor side, GD doing a fantastic job just really focusing on decoding. And that is the forward on the chair right here. And since the Seer was able to get away right here, it's the same thing as we saw before. Survivor's actually trying to take their turns on the chair, but it seems like OSM already found out where the Seer might hide and is going, wait, that was the Seer's leech that was, it disappeared.
Yeah, it was. Oh my gosh. So yeah, it was the Seer, but the mechanic was the one that went for that save, but then no Tide Turner was popped. So we are seeing another round on the rocket chair for that forward. That Seer, I believe, is over at the graveyard. The Seer now is out of sight and out of mind. Oh no, switching back over to the graveyard, and we see that the Seer is in that area. So again, Last Human is not going to be deterred. He still wants to be able to chair this forward and probably going to change his sights and go to the graveyard for that Seer.
Look at the Cypher machines. That might be an opening right here to prepare the Cypher pops. We can see that the Seer was getting rid of the leech. Seer was having it at 99% to actually get away from the leech. Was probably just having it there. Wait, that blink did not hit, did it?
Yeah, it did not. The mechanic was too slippery there, and also as well as the mercenary. So again, excellent save here. And as you mentioned, Grizz, I think they're primed and ready for that Cypher pop. Just waiting for that Tide Turner. The Last Human is positioning himself because he is prepping for that late game.
But look at that, exactly, is positioning all the leeches around. It is again the middle Cypher on this map, and that's going to be a very, very difficult task. But at the same time, we have Maka, who still has all life and could just go in and decode, take a hit and pop off the Cypher. That might be a chance for them. We can see that they are all preparing for the late game right now, healing up in the bottom left. We can see the forward just healing the Seer, and at the same time, the other way around, Seer healing the forward, just getting the health up. We can see that Last Human is getting ready. Oh, nice hit for the Last Human right here. It's gonna be difficult to pop off that last Cypher machine, but at the same time, we have all survivors still alive up and running. So that might be a chance for them to separate and to outplay the Last Human. But what will happen, we will have to see.
Yeah, Mechanic gets hit, and now you see that it was a great job that they were going for those heals. Now they're working on a Cypher over at Graveyard just to spread out the Dream Witch, right? What OSM did in the previous round, they were able to find other options. You see that the Graveyard is being touched, but it's still far from completion because the one at the center is the one that is so close. I believe the stun happened, and you see that he is camping. He is guarding this last Cypher with his life. The Mercenary hits the second hit. The delayed effect will be popped. And again, another leech gone. So we see there's only one main body leech that is just guarding the Cypher. So still anyone's game.
The Last Human doing just a fantastic job, really protecting both Cypher machines they are trying to work on. But at the same time, the Cypher machine at the graveyard is getting progress right here, as we can see on the left side. It definitely is a game that is going over the 10-minute mark yet again, because is just such a back and forth between the survivors and the hunter. But if we compare this game to the game that we saw before, where GD was on the hunter side, where GD was hunting as Dream Witch, we already had one survivor out of the game at this point, and that is definitely a huge advantage. That was definitely a huge advantage for GD, and that might be the reason why these survivors are able to bring down another Cypher machine this good.
Look at that.
Exactly. It is primed. We can expect a rescue and a Cypher pop as soon as the survivor goes down. Let's see what is happening. A rescue is happening.
Yeah, going for the rescue now, and waiting for the end game, waiting for that last pop to happen, or that last hit. Going for the mercenary, interesting. Oh, gets the stun! So will they push for it? We see that the crows are going on Mata's side. Wanted Order gives him a little field of vision where the seer is.
There we go.
That hit, and we have the end game, Grizz.
Absolutely amazing. Ford was wanting that hit because he knew, okay, I'm gonna get rid of the leech. If I'm not taking the hit, I'm gonna get rid of the leech by myself. And if I'm taking that hit, Cypherpop will happen and I'm fine and ready to go. And this is exactly what happened. We now have two leeches on the ground, the main body leech as well as a leech on Kit, as we can see in the on the right side. That might be very, very difficult for OSM to get the 5 points right now, because even with the Dream Witch, which is an extremely... Oh, nice landing that strike right here. But in the bottom left, we can see the gate is being opened. Again, even with the Dream Witch, which is very strong late game, it can be difficult to get... Or not necessarily can be, it is extremely difficult to get more than... two survivors with the Dream Witch late game when they are opening up gates and splitting up to the left and the right.
Yeah, and GGs go out to GD. Excellent coordination there. They knew